Valet parking is $5. Valet of the Dells is not responsible for lost or stolen articles.
Dale, I'm just gonna park in my driveway.
That lot's full, but Bill says I can put overflow parking poolside at Luann's house. Octavio! La bomba le automobilo. No scratcho. Comprende?
Out of the way.
Octavio, I want you to do the exact same thing I just did to this picture, to this guy in person. Except do it right here.
Okay, I'm gonna need $20 now, and $20 when it is done. And another $20 for expenses.
Yeah. 11:15 a.m. The man and the boy and the puppy leave the house.
11:16, Octavio speaks into tape recorder. Thus leaving crucial evidence, stupid idiot! Octavio must be gotten rid of. Dear Octavio, this is the hardest letter I've ever had to write. Dear Octavio, it has come to my attention that a man claiming to be Dale Gribble recently fired you.
Perimeter breach.
Perimeter breach? Ah! What information have you brought me, Octavio?
Bill is losing weight, I say. He's eating only oranges and ham sandwiches.
Blast it! We will still win, but we must train twice as hard. Octavio, release the chicken. Bok, bok, bagok, so that's the way it is.
Look at Dale over there, all smug on his Mason 5000. You're gonna eat my exhaust fumes, Gribble.
Keep talking, Bubble Butt.
I wasn't saying anything.
Not you, I was talking to Hank.
One minute.
All right, Octavio, now that the inspection is over, hook up the nitrous oxide to my engine.
That's illegal, no?
Yes. But it'll give me a boost of speed. Add that to the natural quickness of the Mason 5000, and I just might overcome my weak driving skills. And come on, you graceful gazelle! Ah! Dang, cheating Octavio blew my engine!
Dale Gribble on the Mason 5000!
Well, folks, earlier I made some comments that were deemed insensitive by one of my key sponsors, Dale's Deadbug, who pulled all his ads, coward. And I can't drum up any news sales since I'm stuck behind this f***ing microphone 24 hours a day. So, I have been forced to sell the station to Mexican interests. Viva la revolucion, Octavio.
Buenos dias, amigos. Presentamos el rey de la polka, Flaco Jiménez, con el bolón ping-pong.
Mr. Hill, Mr. Gribble alleges that you intentionally severed his finger.
Your Honor, it was an accident. We're wasting valuable legal resources here.
Objection, conjecture. Objecture.
That's not a word.
Mr. Hill, please control your outbursts. I am issuing a restraining order. You are not to go within 100 feet of Mr. Gribble.
What? That is crazy. I live within 100 feet of him. How am I going to fix the house that he ruined?
Hank Rutherford Hill, you are within 100 feet of me, and much as I like to scoff at the law, I also like to arbitrarily enforce it. Skedaddle, boy, we got a tunnel to dig under the alley.
What?
Yeah, it's gonna go from Dale's house to my house to Boomhauer's house.
Little three-way friendship tube, and you ain't invited.
The only rules are no spitting and no cutting other people's fingers off. You probably wouldn't like it down there, Hank.
Yeah, man, talking about no dang old psychos allowed, man.
Good God, you're serious? The alley is city property. As block captain, I will come down on you with the full authority of my office. And who the hell are you?
Hank, you know Octavio. He's my gal Friday. Does anything I want. Now you, scoot. 100 feet. Move it.
You shut your god-dang mouth, or I'll shove that ditch witch down your throat and dig a tunnel straight through to sunshine.
That's telling him.
Yeah, felt good, too.
Back off, Hank, or Octavio will mess you up.
Gribble, I don't care if he stays or goes. Where's the money you owe me, Esse?
You heard him.
Take the first shot, Cochise. I love two things, building dollhouse furniture and kicking ass. And I don't see no dollhouses around here. You see any dollhouses, Hank?
No, I don't.
No, you don't. That's right. What are you looking at, sport? Don't you eyeball me.
Can I get in on this?
Well, who the heck are you?
Octavio, dude.
We're trying to talk about the Bible here.
Oh, sure, you see. I'm way into it. Hey, look what I got. Jesus.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Hey, that's Rob Zombie.
Shut up, kid.
He got my Bible wet.
Okay, Joseph, Octavio, no more fellowship hugs. Not until you show me you're here to learn the Bible, not get it wet.
So Paul was named Saul until he saw Jesus on the road to Damascus and changed his ways.
That's right. Fellowship hug.
Oh, boy.
So when the Bible says he is without sin should cast the first stone, what it's saying is...
What it's saying is we should look at our own sins, try to be better people.
Yes, but if you...
Sure, but you can't be a better person just by acting all righteous and stuff. It says right here in the book of Acts that... the red letters are the Jesus words, right?
I have strayed far and long from the path of the righteous. I have sinned. I have lied. I have fornicated on stolen antique furniture. But I will tell you this. The good Lord sets the most beautiful table for the son who's eaten from the most dumpsters.
Doctor, how is he?
You're the new Gribble, right? I need to talk to you.
Octavio?
It's Tuesday. I need you to break my fender.
What? Are you asking me to help you commit some kind of fraud?
Are you backing out on me, new Gribble? We had a deal. And now we drink.
It's 10 a.m.
Now we drink.
Octavio?
Yo, ese, where's Gribble's kidney? I lined up a buyer in Caracas. He outbid this dude in Ireland by 40 euros.
Dale's kidney isn't in there. It's at the hospital.
Oh. Hi.
Dale, here's your power of attorney back. You were right. It isn't easy being you.
I know. Did you get me the alien urine?
Yep. Cost $319.
That's my rate. And you assisted Octavio.
Bashed his fender with rebar.
That's my M.O. Hank, it sounds like you did it.
Con! Con, get your men.
Con has men?
Take Hank to the cage.
There's a cage?
Come on!
You can't do this. Let go of me. Hey!
I swear, I don't know how all the toilet paper got under my cot.
God dang it, Bill. What's gotten into you? You are out of control.
Strong leaders always make enemies, and that's why they make strong cages.
Cage was my idea.
Ugh.
Thanks for the tip, Con.
What?
You show terrible judgment in trusting me. How can I follow you? Can I have my bullhorn back now?
Sure. The batteries are dead, but you can wave it around.
Oh, no.
Hank. What am I going to do with you?
Psst. Bloomers! Get in the car.
Why? I just got here.
Hey, I'm driving you to the green room, Esse. I got all kinds of cheeses back there. Gribble.
Got him.
Good. Make him disappear.
You want me to kill him?
What? No! Although, no, just drive him around. But I'm happy you're being proactive. There are no bad ideas.
Mr. Gribble, I'd like to thank you for coming today with your counsel.
Don't answer that.
It wasn't a question, Counselor. It was a pleasantry.
Don't look at me.
Mr. Gribble, with your counsel's permission, and mind you, I'm not looking at him, I would like to address your lack of insurance. Now, my client's injuries resulted from an incident involving pesticide spray. Who makes your pesticide? And the answer I'm looking for is one of the deep pocket poison makers. Dow, DuPont, Sibagaigi.
I make my own.
Oh, okay. What about the stairs Lucky fell down? Were they built by a large developer, successful contractor?
I built them. Without a permit.
Well, Dale's dead bug gets us nothing. If you want to play hardball, we could probably take Gribble's house.
Yeah, let's take Gribble's house.
No, don't take Gribble's house. Believe me, you don't want it. There's so many liens and assessments against it, Gribble barely owns it.
Yeah. No, it's still better than nothing.
I'm sorry, Dale.
Damn Hank for making me hire you.
Hank? Who's Hank?
I got it! Connie! You drop that right now and wash your hands!
Dale, you got the tickets?
Yep. One for you, you, and you.
Texas versus Nebraska? Dale, you idiot, you bought fake tickets.
Impossible. Well played, Octavio. Octavio, I have a job for you. Bring your shovel. Oh, sorry, Mrs. Octavio. You sound just like him.
Wouldn't we be doing more good for the planet if we were planting trees?
Octavio and I have the planting covered.
We're gonna run out of trees soon, they say. Should we go buy some more?
We got all the trees we need, Octavio. I mean, who knows how many carbons are soaked up by a single tree? 17? 30 billion?
This one's pretty leafy, but, you know, I don't know, dude.
Nobody does. Let's go get some lunch.
Done.
Ah, great.
Money first.
What the?
They gave it to me and it had a bite out of it, you know.
This is crazy. Does Nancy know what you're doing here?
Maybe you like to bore Peggy with all your little projects, but I'm not going to bore my wife with mine.
Hey, Gribble, where should I put the walrus before he wakes up?
Joseph's bed.
Tell him I want my kiddie pool and my leaf blower.
Okay, next issue. Gribble wants a kiddie pool and his leaf blower back, as well as the alley on Saturdays.
No sale. We already gave you the Arlen High football tickets and the alley every other Sunday.
What the heck is going on here? You from my dad. Cotton brought that fork back from Germany. I'm pretty sure he killed somebody with it.
It's beautiful. I love getting gifts, Hank. I'm pretty sure Dale doesn't know that, though, since he hasn't gotten me anything for my birthday for the last 14 years. That's right, I counted.
What can you possibly give the man who has nothing?
Look, I could really use both of your help with my dad's estate, so just punch each other or grill a steak and get this ridiculous fight over with.
Meat won't solve this, Hank.
Not this time. So either pick a side or get lost.
Now, where were we? Tell him
more about it. Gribble's gonna need that fork.
No way!
It'll go well with his knife.
Give him fork, Dotrief.
Gentlemen, today I achieved a significant milestone. I killed my 10,000th rat. Mrs. Dumphy's Weimaraner gets co-credit, but I got my mallet in there.
Oh, man, wow. Like a dang old exclusive club, man.
Well, congratulations, Dale. That's exciting news.
Hey, Gribble, the trophy shop said this was the biggest plaque they had.
Thank you, Octavio. He was supposed to be mid-roar.
So, Bill, what have you been up to?
I gave my 10,000th army haircut. Mm-hmm. And I'm getting a plaque.
Wait a second. I feel like I saw that in a movie or something.
You disguise certain facts, I said, but the story is Gribble's intellectual property.
Bill, tell us something that's happened to you.
Well, recently I stole Dale's story and tried to pass it off as mine. I'm a boring man and I have no life.
So, Boomhauer, what's new with you?
So, here's the place. Oh, hi. This is Octavio and his brothers. They're going to be living here, too, as my guests.
From now on, I park in the driveway, I say.
Driveway space is mine.
Roommate vote. Who wants the scary new guys to leave?
Who wants the scary new guys to stay?
Tiebreaker!
If the dude filming this takes one more call on his cell, man, I'm turning this off.
Who drank my soy milk?
I didn't see no name on it.
I drew a bunny on it. Same thing.
Hey, we're not taking crap from an ex-centerfold.
You listen to me. Once a bunny, always a bunny.
Uh-oh. Are my roommates not getting along? Maybe a few of you want to move out.
Casual encounter? South of Rainy Street is mine for perfume, Missy.
It's different demographic. Don't be baby.
Baby? I'll show you baby.
Let's go!